My name is Stephanie Robert. I am a research civil engineer in the structural engineering branch of GSL, and I am the program manager for the Family of High Military Low Class Bridging Program here at ERDC. And so what we're doing here is we're doing small-scale prototype testing of the improved ribbon bridge. So the IRB allows our forces to construct a bridge that in any environment that they need to do in an expedited manner, because it's deployed off of the back of a CBT. And so they can go out and deploy this bridge, assemble it together, and then they can move their troops to the far side and secure the far shore as quickly as possible. This program has multiple facets involved in it. We have people from GSL, we have people from ITL, we have people from CHL all working together to solve one of the problems that we were issued to solve. And so what we did in the summer was we did a full-scale prototype testing of the improved ribbon bridge. And now what we're doing is adding hydrodynamic effects to that same testing and using what we did in the summer to validate the testing as well as determine operational conditions that we can operate the IRB.
The test that we're doing here today is going to inform us on the safe operating conditions of the IRB when crossing with the new Abrams tank, because the Abrams is heavier now than ever before. So now we just need to make sure that our tactical float bridges like the IRB are capable of carrying it, and so that we can transport, you know, and move across rivers and what we call wide wet gap crossings. The main difference here is we had to make some assumptions on the rigid bodies of the bays to scale them down to the 1 to 12, but otherwise everything hydrodynamically is the same. And so the responses here can be directly correlated to what's going to happen in the prototype. So we take a lot of care to make sure that we choose a scale where the hydrodynamic forces that we get here can be correlated up to the large scale. Here, we can introduce river velocities, you know, so we can ramp the river velocity up or down depending on, you know, whatever we're trying to simulate. And we can test that, because what happens is as the water comes in and it impacts the IRB, it does change the hydrodynamics. And so the bridge likes to move a certain way, and we also have bow wave. And so what can happen is there is an operational space where it's just too much flow for the bridge. And as you add more weight, that operational space changes. And so the way to do that safely is in a scale model. So here, we don't have to worry about sinking the tank or sinking the bridge, and we can try a lot of different scenarios out without any risk to anybody or any property.
These are motion tracking cameras. So it's a complete motion tracking system that we use to track individual response data of the model IRB. And then what we can do with that data is translate it to real world conditions so that we can get an accurate representation of how the improved ribbon bridge is behaving under different conditions, hydrodynamically and load wise, in a risk-free environment. So the cameras use infrared technology to reflect off of markers that are uniquely placed on the bridge itself, and then it translates that data into 6 degrees of freedom, so translations and rotations about your three axes, X, Y, and Z, and then we can use that to evaluate the actual bridge response. That will lead to us being able to confidently say whether or not the IRB can be used to cross different military loaded vehicles under different hydrodynamic conditions.
So with this data we have here today, and we'll use that, you know, we're going to use that with the data that we got from the structural testing and the still water testing that you saw at the prototype scale. We'll use all that together to kind of inform a final decision point, a final stance that ERDC stands behind from an engineering perspective.